see the teachers, they will think of reducing their workloads. How? If a teacher is a nursery teacher, she of course is a mother. If a teacher is in a primary classroom, she will be a subject teacher, right? If there are many sections of one class, let's say class 5 is having 4 sections or 5 sections, she is an English teacher for all the 5 sections, she will have less workload compared to if she is an English teacher of the class 2, 3, 4 and 5. Did you understand what I am trying to say? Because she will have to go through the syllabus of each and every class, and then she has to explain to the children. She has to first understand herself, then teach to the children. In the other case, when she is looking after 4 sections, she has to work one time only to understand, but then she can give the 4 lectures same time, like what she has given to any one section. So, for your case, the teacher saying that you are running fast is because she wants to explain the same thing over the 2 weeks or the 2-3 days. It is easier for her. If you have to introduce only one alphabetic or one thing letter in a week, maybe that is more easy than introducing 3 letters in a week or 3 or 2. Right. As I said, you should see the type of problem, you should know why the teacher is making such an excuse. If you have another set of teachers also, if they also face that type of problem, they should be in house discussion first. First is we expect the agent to find with your experience and everything, you should be finding a solution to that. And if you feel like during the inspection we have seen many branches were lacking behind. Why? Because the same reason. The HMs were going the way the teachers are telling them to go. They are not going the way how we are telling them. Later on you will have a problem. Parents will come and say at the end of the session, sir, book to itni thi, aapne to aadhi hi khatam kar. Or what you will be doing, you will be running fast in the last few months of the session and the children will not understand anything. Here they will be revising. That revision should take place over the period, same week, next week. They will become confident. There should be mock tests, there should be interactive sessions with the students, there should be some class tests, whatever is possible. That you have to do. Okay? And you know, there was another point also, any other point? Okay. We have Mr. Vaibhav Saklani, I think you members will know, our director from the Rishikesh branch. He is there with us and Mr. Navdeep, or he also attends from the Rishikesh. We have joined, we have our new branch from Shimla College, Mr. Prajita. He is just joined in the Rishikesh College. And coming to this, before this I am about to tell you about something which we got in the feedback form. There was one question which I asked, how frequently should this inspection happen? 3 months, 6 months, or once in a year? How many of you have written 3 months? Raise that. your view who mentioned 1 year, one time only, sir. 6 months में एक ही बार होगा तो बहुत ही अच्छा है. क्यों? अरे क्योंकि मांग करती है, बेकार में पकड़ी जाती है, क्या जरूरत है इतनी जल्दी जल्दी इंस्पेक्शन करने की. और वैसे भी स्कूल तो चल ही रहा है तो, और हमारे ऊपर वर्कलोड आ जाता है कि भाई अब इंस्पेक्शन होगा, पता नहीं कब होगा, सब कुछ ठीक करो, यह नहीं करो, ये करो. दिस इंस्पेक्शन is something like you are taking a class test of your students to know how much they know. We take an inspection to see how much things actually the HMs are doing in their branches, whether they are running profession fine, whether the syllabus is in line, what are the problems you are facing. If there is any genuine problem, sometimes what happens is we are in a service industry. If the curriculum goes from our side to you all, and I'm not saying it is 100% sure from correct curriculum or something like this, but if you people are facing a mistake, if it is a mistake or if it is a problem which people face all across in all the branches, then definitely we will have to look into it and find a solution, right? So that is a way where we can come to know if there any problem which is happening, if we need to address. So that it is taken care of in the future. Also, in a way, the branches become little more attentive towards whatever is being sent, implemented and done in there. Right? So that is what is important. Okay, we have this monthly performance report which all of you are, all the HMs are already aware about it. Okay, this is the point tally which presently we have. And let me check towards the slide. What we have this time is 2002. Very good score by Rishikesh Branch. Congratulations, ma'am. Congratulations, there was an excellent one. Next is 1977, very good. Rajpur Road branch, and the third position was Vasant Vihar. So Vasant Vihar, where it was like 1896. Good. And then it is Dalmala with 1792. Okay. Okay, I'll tell you something about this. See, when you are filling up the sheet, number of admissions closed, as ma'am was mentioning, when we get a checklist, it has some figure. We check in the ERP, different figure. We find in your report is imperfect. How to verify? That is why I have made that one form so that we come to know. You will know each and every part. There is an importance to everything. If you think in head office they will not check, she makes the report, sends the report every week to me, and I get the report for all the classes she has got about to do. And when I cross question, then she says, yes sir, I will have to check. So don't think that nobody is checking, nobody is seeing, and there is nothing happening. So this thing monitor and all the points we are watching. So there is number of admissions where we found the discrepancy happening. Then there was second point. Okay, so there is where the discrepancy was there. Then there is one more point I'll tell you. There is one point mentioned. Person how you are coming to this figure?